President Trump begins a week-long visit to Europe commemorating the 75th anniversary of D-Day. It all started with a royal welcome in Britain, where turmoil over Brexit has left the country in confusion. President Trump jumped right into the debate, sparring with top officials. White House correspondent Mark Irons reports. Good evening, Mark.
Good evening, Lauren. President Trump marks the official state visit to Britain as he continues a verbal battle with the mayor of London. The president leaves behind turmoil here in Washington to enter a political firestorm in the UK.
A royal gun salute for President Trump as his state visit got underway. Queen Elizabeth greeting him at Buckingham Palace, and tea time with Prince Charles marking the start of the ceremonial week ahead, complete with D-Day commemorations and his first official presidential visit to Ireland. The pageantry in Britain comes a day after the president fought off Democratic cries for his impeachment back home.
There is no basis whatsoever for impeachment. None. There was no collusion, there was no obstruction, there was no crime.
President Trump leaves fallout from the Russia investigation and enters Britain's own brand of political turbulence following failed attempts to secure a Brexit deal. It caused British Prime Minister Theresa May's resignation, and President Trump hasn't been shy about jumping into the controversy, endorsing Conservative Boris Johnson as her replacement.
Well, I may meet with him. He's been a friend of mine. He's been very nice. I have a very good relationship with him.
If Johnson represents a political ally in England, London's mayor has become a vocal foe. Mayor Sadiq Khan declares the president a political far-right menace to liberal democracy around the world, writing, "Donald Trump is just one of the most egregious examples of a growing global threat." President Trump firing back, "He is a stone-cold loser who should focus on crime in London, not me. Khan reminds me very much of our very dumb and incompetent mayor of NYC, de Blasio, who has also done a terrible job."
And despite audio recording that proves otherwise, the president denies describing the Duchess of Sussex, Meghan Markle, as nasty just days ago. He was responding to her criticism of him in 2016. Now today, the president said the royal family has been fantastic, noting relations with the UK are very strong. And he adds, great love all around. Lauren.
White House correspondent Mark Irons. Thank you, Mark.